Immigrant advocates say some of the most vulnerable immigrants, victims of domestic violence and unaccompanied minors, could potentially be deported even though they are eligible for a visa, because the courts will not set their cases aside. In a December speech, Sessions skewered the Obama administration for closing nearly 200,000 pending immigration court cases without a final decision over a five-year period. "We are completing, not closing, immigration cases," he said. About 542,000 cases were pending 3 weeks before Trump took office in January 2017, according to a Department of Justice estimate. Since then, the backlog has grown by another estimated 145,000 cases, a 27% increase. In comparison, the Obama administration added an average of 41,000 cases to the backlog each year, according to data from the Transactional Records Access Clearinghouse, TRAC, a New York-based research organization. Opposing views: Trump was elected on a platform of tightening border security and speeding the removal of people living in the country illegally. Early in his presidency, he announced that all categories of immigrants in the country illegally would be considered targets for deportation. Groups advocating stricter immigration enforcement have long opposed the policy of administrative closure. "We see this as one more example of attempts by the Obama administration to work around the rules of law," said Michael Hateman, senior counsel with the conservative Immigration Reform Law Institute in Washington. In a legal filing in the Sessions review, the American Bar Association cautioned that withdrawal of administrative closure would have profound and long-lasting consequences on the operation of the immigration adjudication system and the lives of those who must proceed through it. "Running from the gangs after gangs shot her father, paralyzing him and placing him permanently in a wheelchair, Jennifer Mendoza fled Honduras by herself in 2016. She was 10 years old." Mendoza's lawyer, Vicky Dobrin, said the case shows how aggressively the government is fighting closures. "Prosecutors used to routinely support closing cases like Mendoza's," said Dobrin. "Within a few months, they were starting to oppose everything," she said. Ashley Tabadidier, president of the Immigration Judges Union, said the pushback from prosecutors has meant more work for judges. "The case is going to take much longer and is going to take more resources," she said.